Yeah, man, I was soaring down through the mountains with an elk strapped in my back, and it was pretty wild. We'll get into it, but are we rolling, Jamie? All right. You want to do the cans?
Yeah.
Why don't you put on the headphones?
How's that?
All right, good. We're live. Awesome. Welcome, man.
It's great to be here. Thanks for having me.
If you can just move this mic closer to your mouth.
Like this?
Closer.
It's good.
Keep going. Closer. Closer. Like, make sure it just touches your lips like that. Right there. Why don't you tell the audience who you are and why you're here?
Yeah, so my name's Aaron Massey. Most of your audience probably doesn't know who I am. I'm a creator. I'm a filmmaker, photographer, actor, writer, and I make stuff.
Jamie, am I hearing something in my headphones? It's just, they're drilling on the roof. Okay.
Well, thanks for having me again, first off. This is pretty wild to be here. So yeah, I mean, really what I wanted to kind of bring to topic today was 2021, you know, especially after the year that we had, you know.
I don't know if we're the only ones here, though, you know.
Okay.
You came with some steps. I love steps.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's go through them, man. Tell me what you want to talk about. We can talk about anything.
I have 6 tips to basically crush 2021.
Right.
So first thing is action versus inaction. So to sum it all up.
Yeah.
You know, most of us, we want things for ourselves and for our families. And we want to lead a certain lifestyle that we imagine. Would you agree that action creates change?
Action is everything, right?
Right.
Yeah.
So that's really one thing that I'm focusing on this year. Instead of kind of always going into this analysis by paralysis method where you can research yourself to death.
It's an interesting concept that you're talking about. And I think a lot of people might benefit from it. I believe in it. I believe in what you're saying.
So for me in 2021, I really want to, not only for myself, but spread the notion to other people that action creates change. So if you want something to happen in your life, you have to physically take action, not just think about something changing for you, not just hoping something changes for you, but to actually take that action step,
whatever
it's like
it is.
The action of taking my bow back and the arrow ripping through an elk, and then I get to feed my family with that elk meat on a Traeger grill.
Oh, that's interesting. Jamie, see if you can find a picture of me pulling a bow and arrow back and shooting an elk.
So this next step for me is something that I want to progress for my own personal growth. And no matter what scale this is for you, there's ways to do it. So the topic comes down to travel for me. So step 2 is travel. Now what travel does is, for me, it opens up growth potential. I lived in a different city for 11 years, and I grew exponentially because of that. I lived in Los Angeles for a while.
Right.
I know your opinion on it. It's one of those things where I grew as a person. Just, you know, I come from the Midwest.
Jamie's from Ohio.
And one thing that did for me was provide me with different outlets, basically speaking with other people, getting to know other cultures.
I'd expand a little bit more on the travel idea.
It doesn't necessarily have to be this big thing, like you're going overseas or anything.
Yeah.
Once we're able to do that, after we get through all this madness of the pandemic, I want to be able to get to a place where I can travel. And first, it's going to start domestically.
I think for a lot of people, travel can be difficult, right?
You might say, hey, I don't really have the money. I don't have the time. What I would suggest is potentially travel within your city. Start there and get outside of your bubble a little bit. So if you only go to the same restaurants, or if you only go to the same parks,
right,
if you only bike on the same bike path, try to start getting outside of that bubble. That's as close as it can be, and you don't have to spend money to do that. I still consider that traveling. You're going and experiencing new things. You're running up against new people. I hear what you're saying. So if you have a town next to you or you only go to certain restaurants, start to expand that a little bit. Try different things. Try a different ethnic restaurant that you've never been to before. Do you think people would benefit from eating more elk meat? Never tried it.
It's the best.
You know, I'd be interested.
Traeger grill. Cook it on a Traeger grill.
But I think for me, it's all about exploring and having the time on the road, getting away from the computer screens and the phones all the time, and being putting myself out into a position in nature that's actually a little bit vulnerable, and going to camp and hike in places that I've never been before and experiencing those moments.
It's about getting out there, being one with nature, you know?
It's going to open your world up, I think.
And when you're out there, we have too much light pollution. You can't even see the stars. We can't feel small enough.
Grow from those experiences, because I'm all about growth. And I think travel is a major factor in us as humans in terms of our growth rates. We are explorers at heart. And you can take that, you can take that generalization of being an explorer literally from getting outside of your bubble in your hometown.
Elon Musk does. Elon Musk wants to live on Mars. Not me, man. No way. It's a weird world.
Yeah.
Do you ever think about aliens? There's gotta be. There's gotta be aliens out there. You know?
Yeah, man.
It's just, there's too much space, man.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Do you know how big space is? It's the biggest thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, it's like the TikTok UFO, right? TikTok. Why do I keep saying TikTok? Tic-tac UFO. 60,000 feet to 6 feet in 1 second. Is it Commander? Yeah, Commander Jack Frager. Traeger Grill?
So the third tip is to know your self-worth.
Explain that a little bit for the audience.
So I speak a lot in regards to creatives, right? That's kind of my topic of what I talk about a lot. But a lot of what I discuss can be broadened out to general life. And anyone can take this advice. And knowing your self-worth for me has become really important, because there's a lot of people, especially in the arts communities, that have a lot of self-doubt because they've dealt with so much rejection in their lives, whether you're a painter, a musician, an actor, a writer.
Oh, I love musicians, man. Jimi Hendrix, oh, it's the best there ever was, hands down. No debate. Jamie, see if you can pull up a video of Jimmy. You can't play it? We'll get kicked off YouTube? Okay.
Generally speaking, unless you're struck by lightning and you just automatically get this golden ticket, the majority, like 99% of people, if not more than that, that are in the arts industries, suffer from years of rejection. And
it's a great point, Matt.
It's not all a bad thing, because it makes you work for what you truly want. And it kind of weeds people out, right?
Right.
But within that, psychologically, everyone's kind of dealing with their own shit. You know what I mean? And so self-doubt creeps in there for artists. And I'm trying to promote the fact that we need to support each other as creatives. And for you personally as a creative to know your self-worth. So stop letting people tell you that you're not good enough. Check in with yourself. Make sure you're doing the right things to get better at your craft. But know your self-worth. Know that if you face rejection on a daily basis, that it doesn't mean you're a bad artist.
Right.
It's not the case. You just have to keep fighting through that. And knowing your self-worth will allow you to positively move forward.
Well, I think you're bringing a lot of value to the people.
So, the fourth one for me is compassion for others. So one thing that I want to work on in 2021 is showing compassion for others. Because, you know, if you're dealing with someone who is not very nice to you, I've learned to step back from that situation and look at the overall picture. And instead of myself getting angry or upset, which will then lead my day into a negative place, I'm looking at a way to be compassionate for this person, even though they weren't nice. What you're saying, compassion for other people, is a pretty far out theory. Maybe. Well, just no one's doing it. What that does is allows you to understand that, hey, maybe they're going through a divorce. Maybe they have a sick kid. Maybe they just lost their job. You don't know what people are going through. We are all going through shit. We're not all having a great day. And so I've learned to step back from situations.
That's great.
Generally, what happens is I understand that there's something going on in their life, or they're dealing with something, or they haven't dealt with something.
Mm.
So instead of being reactive to that, I've learned to step back, have a little bit more compassion, more empathy towards a general situation that you may not know about. And that, I think, will help me. And I think if we all do that this year, not knowing what people's situations are, let us get through the day a little bit easier.
No, right.
It'll allow us to be nicer to each other.
That's a great point. It's a great point. I think a lot of people need to hear that. Tell me about it. I have compassion for Elk. Jamie, see if you can pull up a picture of elk meat on my Traeger grill.
No way.
So what else you got?
All right, here's a biggie, Joe. Number five, you ready?
Yeah.
All right. Setting habits, not goals.
Habits.
Right? Mm. I don't want to say that I don't believe in goals, but I want to make people cautious about setting New Year's goals, right?
It's all about habit. That's why I take Alpha Brain at 6 a.m. every day.
Look, it's great to write stuff down on paper. I believe in that. Get some things out. But unless, you know, if you have a list of 10 ideas that you want to change, or goals that you want to accomplish in the year ahead, but you don't take action, number one, remember? Unless you do that, nothing's going to change. And how do you do that? It's by setting up those goals as habits.
If Conor McGregor didn't practice his flippy kick spins, then he would not be a champion.
Uh-huh.
I know MMA. I know this sport. I know why he's a champion.
Have you ever met him?
Jamie, see if you can pull up a picture of Conor McGregor with his shirt off. Do you like UFC?
Sometimes.
If you're not in a routine, then you're losing in life. You're a loser.
So structuring your day, if your goal is to lose weight, you better have it as a habit that at whatever time, if it's 6 a.m., you're at the gym or you're in a room in your home, work, you know, if it's push-ups, sit-ups, whatever it is that you have decided on to help you with your goal, to make that a habit. Because and that means daily. It's this daily structure. So unless you're doing that, you can write as many goals on a piece of paper as you want.
Do you know Jordan Peterson?
No.
Really smart guy. He lost a lot of weight.
Okay.
I'm trying a carnivore diet where I just eat meats and then have diarrhea.
Really?
Oh, for like days, man. Brutal.
So for me, I know that I'm setting up daily habits. And then what that does is it allows you to get into this consistency where you're not even thinking about it anymore. You know, like at 6 a.m., you're there. There's no questions asked.
That's pretty cool, man.
So just remember, rule number five, set up habits, not goals.
I think a lot of people would try to fight with you on what you're saying.
Yeah, maybe.
But I agree with you.
This is the good one, Joe, number six. It's a pretty simple one that we all forget sometimes. And it's having fun.
Having fun. That's a great one.
A lot of people don't like to think this way, but for me, it helps. I remind myself constantly that tomorrow may be the last one you got.
Mm.
This life could end at any moment. And I don't want to be on my deathbed, number one, regretting choices that I made in life or non-choices, non-action, things that I didn't do. That's my number one fear. But ultimately, it coincides with not living the life that you want. And for me, that's about doing what I want and having fun doing it. Tomorrow could be your last. It's a great way of looking at it. So incorporating fun into my life, meaning letting go of the stress around situations that I know I can't control, and understanding that tomorrow could be my last day on this planet, I'm forcing myself to be in this moment right now and enjoy it. Jamie, see if you can pull up a picture of someone having fun. And it's one of these practices that I've really started to incorporate into my life, and I want to share that with people. Yeah, because, man, I think a lot of people can benefit from it. And it's a general idea, but I think each person needs to look internally. You know what that is for you. You know how to enjoy the moment around you. Let that sink in. Have fun with what you're doing and really get the most out of life. That's it. Do you like stand-up? You ever been to a show?
Yeah, man.
Jamie over there. Every day, man. Every day. You got to live it. You got to live it up, just like you're saying. These are great points. These are great points.
What about you? Do you think you'll take on any of those steps, Joe?
Oh, undeniably. I think people should know that you exist. I think people should subscribe to you on YouTube. It's just going to make the world a better place. And that's my opinion.
Thanks, man.
Jamie, can you put up a like button so everyone knows what that's like on the page? I want people to click the like button on this video. Listen, this has been an awesome conversation. I really enjoyed talking with you today. It's been really great, man.
Thanks, Joe, for having me. I really appreciate it.
Come back, man. We'll do some stuff. We'll go to a show. This will be nice, man. It's really great meeting
you. Yeah, man.
It's really great meeting you. All right. Before we go, tell everyone where they can find you.
Yeah, people can reach me on YouTube, Aaron Massey. And my Instagram handle is @massive3. Twitter, Aaron_Massey. And my website, AaronMassey.com. So you can reach out to me there, and definitely subscribe to my YouTube channel. Hit that thumbs up button. That helps me a ton.
Awesome. Awesome. Great meeting you, man. Thank you so much.
Really appreciate it. Thanks, Joe.
All right. Goodbye, everybody.